you know, you could say that maybe he can be heavy-handed, like his tweets the other day saying he orders companies out of China. I mean, it would have been far more sensible for him to have said, I advocate that companies leave China, because then it doesn't sound authoritarian and he doesn't sound heavy-handed. But the thing is, people have got to remember, he's 72 years old. You know, he's not a young man. And honestly, Americans, why do you keep electing such old people?
And he's from New York, too.
Yeah, he is. Yeah, yeah. So he's always been a big talker.
Yeah. China devalues their currency. China has slave labor. China is not paying people a fair wage. China is polluting their environment. I mean, if you want to say that, they might say, actually, we've created more forestation. But the point is, all of these different things that they complain in the West, the pollution, the low wages, the authoritarianism, that's all going on in China.
Yeah, that's correct.
And so then Trump just says, hey, let's bring this prosperity back to the West. Let's bring our companies back to the West where they can get paid a fair wage and we can employ Americans. And then somehow the media says, well, that's bad. He can't say that. No, of course, if you're an American company, you should bring your company back to America. Why wouldn't you? But I guess that's the big mystery. Well, why do they love China so much?
The answer is because the Chinese government is essentially facilitating slave labor. I mean, people in China work for a very, very low wage in very, very awful conditions. And when they complain, they instead put up suicide nets around the building to just prevent people from jumping off and killing themselves. China is not a very nice place. It's hugely authoritarian. The social credit system that's going on in China is as Orwellian as it comes, and a warning to the rest of the world is this is what your society could become if you don't keep an eye on what the government and social media's interactions are like.
And I think that's the whole thing, is that China has been engaged in, I mean, it's not even about social engineering necessarily, but they've been...
Oh, I think it is. I think it is about social engineering.
But I think what China's doing differently is that they've already built the infrastructure for the AI to be totally in control. With the facial recognition everywhere, the back doors into everything, that's what they want to see worldwide under a world government. And so you see the protesters in Hong Kong, they're going and literally, they're taking down the facial recognition towers. So it's like the dystopian future of the one world government with an eye on everyone, like the Eye of Sauron, that's already in China in practice, and the people are trying to protest against it. And then they don't even make a news story of it.
Yeah, I think Western countries, and I mean all of them, should have a very firm moral stance on this. It is wrong to do what China is doing. It should not be done in the West, full stop.
But you see, the people that come from China to America are some of the most patriotic people you'll ever meet. Why? Because they dealt with communism. Mm. They dealt with real fascism. They understand and appreciate the freedoms of the West.